like ourselves. I still don't know how to run this thing, but it is great, wonderful, wonderful to see you. And I was really worried we might be out of power because of those rolling blackouts. Usually we have to figure out what we're going to do when that happens, but we don't have to do that today. It's again great to see you. I apologize to those of you who are at the church itself, because you don't have the sermon included in your bulletin, and I understand some of you guys don't either. Be sure, especially worship leaders, always to take the last bulletin I send you, because that is the most complete and the most accurate. I send out a worship leader's bulletin for those of you who want to know the music and stuff. And I think I confused that with the congregational one this Sunday for the church. So I really apologize for that. But it's good to see you. Today, Vern Shonsby is our assisting minister. Kent is our responder. Dale is our reader and special music. We are so blessed. Marty is here. Hallelujah. What a lovely group today.
Wonderful
to see you all. Please notice we do have a gentleman from Idaho, Northern Idaho is here. Hi, Jeff. He's, as you all know, he is Marcia and Kent's son, and he's Trevor. I see the Showquist here too. Hello, how are you guys? Good to see you. Good to see you all. It's always amazing. Heartwarming to see so many here. Remember, we are going to be doing Holy Communion. So gather the elements of what you will need for that, like bread and juice or wine. Wednesday morning at 9:30, we'll hold our Zoom Coffee with Calvary meeting. We'll do Psalm 67. I'll be sending you a Zoom invitation on Tuesday. We have two opportunities to speak with each other at the start. Right before the passing of the peace, I'm hoping that Dorothy will introduce who's in the service, who's at the church today, so we can be sure and wave at you and they can wave at us. And also before at the end of the church service, we'll have another chance to talk if we say farewell to everyone. And I'm sure there are other more relevant announcements that come on Zoom. If you want to talk, be sure and turn on your mic. How about at the church? Anyone, any more announcements to make? Dorothy, do you? So you'll come up now to introduce everybody that you've got. Bless you. I hope you don't mind doing this. We sure like it.
We want to welcome Pam too.
Yes. Pam Leach is here. We can see the top of her head over there. She's really thick. You can turn your screen down a little, and that helps.
Bend your screen down.
The top of your screen, if you just move it down just a little bit.
Where is she?
Or maybe right she there. Is. Anyway. Hi, Dorothy. Who's here today? There you are, Pam. We see you.
She's muted.
Did you mute, Dorothy?
Can't hear you, Dorothy.
I think
okay, we there, I'm unmuted. Okay, I'll start again with Jerry and the sister, but you said, is she sick?
Face this way when she talks.
Okay. Debbie didn't feel well, so she's not here today. And then we go back, I don't know. Kay Ames was here, I don't know where she is at the moment. Carol and Carl Steves, they may be letting some people in.
I saw them.
We'll go over to Kay Harris, who you already saw, and Pat Panay, and ooh, of course, Gary. Now, I don't know, you know, she was always a late arriver when I delivered the bulletin to Ursula yesterday. She did say she was going to try very hard to come. So we know she comes in late, so she may actually be showing up.
I hope so. I would love to see her.
So of course, obviously. We know Pedro's here and Vern and I.
That is a good number. That's a nice number for church. I'm so glad to see you all. If there are no other announcements, we'll begin. We'll begin with the peace. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
We'll continue with the confession. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, whose steadfast love is everlasting, whose faithfulness endures from generation to generation.
Amen.
Trusting in the mercy of God, let us confess our sins. Reconciling God,
we confess that we do not trust your abundance and we deny your presence in our lives. We place our hope in ourselves and rely on our own efforts. We fail to believe that you provide enough for all. We abuse your good creation for our own benefit. We fear difference and do not welcome others as you have welcomed us. We sin in thought, word, and deed. By your grace, forgive us. Through your love, renew us. And in your spirit, lead us so that we may live and serve in newness of life. Amen.
Beloved of God, by the radical abundance of divine mercy, we have peace with God through Christ Jesus, through whom we have obtained grace upon grace. Our sins are forgiven. Let us live now in hope, for hope does not disappoint, because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Time for our first hymn. Jerry and Dennis are going to provide the music, Just As I Am, Without One Plea.
I guess I should, maybe I'll mute myself.
Just as I am without one plea, but that thy blood was shed for me, and that the pains we come to thee.
Thank you very much. We'll continue with the prayer of the day. Let us pray. God of all peoples, your arms reach out to embrace all those who call upon you. Teach us, as disciples of your Son, to love the world with compassion and constancy, that your name may be known throughout the earth, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Special music by Jerry and Dennis.
Our offering today is a medley of one you may or may not know. It's not in too many hymnals, and yet it's out there. Does Jesus Care? It seemed very fitting. If you read the background story, which is in your bulletin, you'll understand a little bit, but I think it's very fitting for this time. And then we're going to echo it with Jesus Loves Me, and I have a little twist in it for you.
Does Jesus care when my heart is pained to deeply mourn mirth and song? As the burden threads and the cares distress, and the way grows weary and long. Oh, yes, he cares, I know he cares. His heart is touched with my grief. When the days are weary, the long nights dreary, I know my Savior cares. Does Jesus care when my way is dark, with a nameless dread and fear? As the daylight fades into deep night shades, does he care? Does Jesus care when I've tried and failed to resist some temptation strong? When for my deep grief I find no relief, though my tears fall the night long? Does Jesus care when I've said goodbye to the dearest on earth to me, and my sad heart aches till it nearly breaks? Is it not to him does he care? Oh, yes, he cares, I know he cares. His heart is touched with my grief. When the days are weary, the long nights dreary, I know my Savior cares. Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong. They are weak, but he is strong. Jesus loves me,
Christmas, I know. Though my hair is white as snow, though my sight is growing dim, still he bids me trust in him. Jesus, take this heart of mine, make it pure and holy thine. On the cross you died for me, I will love and live for thee. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so.
Thank you very much. What fun to hear Jesus Loves Me. That was so nicely done. Thank you very, very much. And I think we all need those words. It's time for our readings. Kent and Dale, be sure and turn on your mics. And we'll begin with the first reading.
You got your mic on, Kent?
Am I reading?
No. You are the responder.
Well, that's what I thought.
And Dale is our reader.
Okay.
Excuse me. I don't have the reading in front of me, and I don't know how to get over to that page. Is there somebody else can pick up that for me? I don't have it in front of me.
Dick, can you read for us today? Be sure and turn on your mic. He said he'd do anything for us.
He won't mow my yard, though.
We got a moment. I'd like to say hello to Geneva. She came. I'm so glad to see you, Geneva. Okay.
Okay, the first reading is from Isaiah chapter 56, beginning with the first verse. The prophet calls upon Israel to do justice in view of God's imminent intervention to save. Righteousness and obedience define who belongs to the Israelite community, not race, nationality, or any other category. A reading from Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, maintain justice and do what is right, for soon my salvation will come, and my deliverance be revealed. And the foreigners who join themselves to the Lord to minister to him, to love them, keep the Sabbath and do not profane it, and hold fast my covenant, these I will bring to my holy mountain and make them joyful in my house of prayer. Their burnt offerings and their sacrifices will be accepted on my altar, for my house shall be called a house of prayer for all peoples. Thus says the Lord God, who gathers the outcasts of Israel, I will gather others to them besides those already gathered. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We'll read the psalm responsively. May God be merciful to us and bless us. May the light of God's face shine upon us.
Let your way be known upon earth, your saving health among all nations.
Let all peoples praise you, O God. Let all the peoples praise you.
Let the nations be glad and sing for joy, for you judge the peoples with equity and guide all the nations on earth.
Let the peoples praise you, O God. Let all the peoples praise you.
The earth has brought forth its increase. God, our own God, has blessed us.
May God give us blessing.
And may all the ends of the earth stand in awe.
The second reading is found in Romans chapter 11, beginning with the first verse. God has not rejected Israel. Rather, the call and gifts of God are irrevocable, so that while all have been disobedient, God has mercy upon all. A reading from Romans. Paul writes, I ask then, has God rejected his people? By no means. I myself am an Israelite, a descendant of Abraham, a member of the tribe of Benjamin. For God has not rejected his people whom he foreknew. For the gifts and the calling of God are irrevocable. just as you were once disobedient to God, but have now received mercy because of their obedience, so they have now been disobedient in order that by the mercy shown to you, they too may now receive mercy. For God has imprisoned all in disobedience, so that he may be merciful to all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We'll continue with special music by Dale.
Shall I try and get this lighter?
You can read it.
It comes out lighter now. It comes in and out.
Dale?
Okay, I think I don't need to have the words in front of me for this one, so I'll...
Take your time.
The latest sun is sinking fast. My race is nearly run. My strongest trials now are past. My triumph has begun. Oh, come, angel band. Come, round me stand, or oh, bear me away on your snowy wings, my immortal home, oh, bear me away on your snowy wings, my immortal home. Oh, bear my longing heart to him who bled and died for me, whose blood now cleanses all from sin, gives me victory. Oh, come, angel band, come and around me stand, oh, bear me away, snowy wings to my immortal with me, and he tells me I am his own, Mary, there, none other has ever known.
Wonderful. Absolutely wonderful. I love both those songs. That was just wonderful. Thank you, Dale. I will continue with the reading of the gospel lesson. The Holy Gospel according to Matthew, the 15th chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus called the crowd to him and said to them, "Listen and understand. It is not what goes into the mouth that defiles a person, but it is what comes out of the mouth that defiles." Then the disciples approached and said to him, "Do you know that the Pharisees took offense when they heard what you said?" Jesus answered, "Every plant that my heavenly Father has not planted will be uprooted. Let them alone. They are blind guides of the blind. And if one blind person guides another, both will fall into a pit." But Peter said to him, "Explain this parable to us." Then Jesus said, "Are you also still without understanding? Do you not see that whatever goes into the mouth enters the stomach and goes out into the sewer? But what comes out of the mouth proceeds from the heart, and this is what defiles. For out of the heart come evil intentions, murder, adultery, fornication, theft, false witness, and slander. These are what defile a person. But to eat with unwashed hands does not defile." Jesus left that place and went away to the district of Tyre and Sidon. Just then, a Canaanite woman from that region came out and started shouting, "Have mercy on me, Lord, Son of David. My daughter is tormented by a demon." But Jesus did not answer her at all. And his disciples came and urged him, saying, "Send her away, for she keeps shouting after us." Jesus answered, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." But she came and knelt before him, saying, "Lord, help me." Jesus answered, "It is not fair to take the children's food and throw it to the dogs." She said, "Yes, Lord, yet even the dogs eat the crumbs that fall from their master's table." Then Jesus answered her, "Woman, great is your faith. Let it be done for you as you wish." And her daughter was healed instantly. Instantly, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
I've been praying and praying the Kyrie eleison recently. But through the centuries, people have prayed the very same prayer, and you've all prayed it too. Remember, long time ago, before the pandemic, on the first Sunday of the month, Vern would lead us in a chant of the Kyrie. There are many variations, but the fundamental parts of the Kyrie are, "Lord have mercy, Christ have mercy, Lord have mercy." The first "Lord" means the Father Almighty, Christ is the Son of God. The second "Lord" means the Holy Spirit. It's a Trinity kind of thing. Anyway, I've been praying here so much to pray about. I just don't. Harsh days. We all have problems upon problems. The nation is burdened by disease, financial chaos, and political unrest. Added and maybe increasing their pain are the personal problems, which are also piling up. Many are suffering. These hard times drag on and on. And they're not just from the virus, but from other reasons as well. Right now, my family suffers. For example, very hard decisions. We all have met, so we're at severe risk complications if we should get the COVID-19. That makes everyday life, let alone returning to school, no easy thing. After months of worry and conversation and struggle, we've agreed that my grandson will do distance learning and that my daughter may well have to resign. It's devastating. These issues have been added to my daily prayer list of the Kyrie. In doing so, I've joined generations of believers who've also struggled through very desperate situations and who've also recited in many languages the same prayer. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Indeed, we need mercy. For God's mercy is described as his power to make all things new. Yes, we need God and his mercy to make whole all of this brokenness. And that's what the woman in the last reading needs too. For there we heard that a Canaanite mother, a foreigner, and a woman who during her historical period ought never speak to any man, shouted at Jesus, Lord, have mercy. The woman pleaded for the Lord to use his power to make her daughter new, for the daughter was tormented by a demon. Yet despite her desperation, Jesus ignored her. But she did bother the disciples who just couldn't stand the shouting. They wanted Jesus to send her away. Apparently, Jesus didn't object. He didn't object. That seems so out of character, for Jesus had often helped other people, including 5,000 that he'd just fed with a little bread and fish. So unexpectedly, Jesus doesn't immediately heal the girl, not this time. When Jesus finally spoke, he dismissed the mother and claimed that he'd been only sent to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. But that desperate mother didn't give up. She pleaded, Lord, help me. In other words, Lord, have mercy on me. Jesus made it worse when he said to her, it's not fair to take the children's food and throw it to the dogs. Oh, how I wish we could hear Jesus' tone or see his face and see what he really intended. Because frankly, this text sounds awful. The words are insulting. Even so, the woman didn't give up. She continued to plead. She knew Jesus was who Jesus was and what his power could do. That's quite a contrast to the story we heard last week, where we heard about the storm-tossed disciples. They struggled to even recognize Jesus. They called him a ghost. But today, that Canaanite mother not only recognized him, she knew about his mercy. So she talked back, holding the Lord to account. She said, call me a dog, but even dogs get crumbs that fall from the table. So the mother knelt before Jesus and begged for his mercy. I wonder, as she was there, if she didn't seek some of those crumbs, just a little mercy. For the woman knew about the basketfuls of crumbs left over after Jesus fed the multitude. Certainly the woman knew the Lord's mercy was the only hope for her daughter. And so she prayed, Lord, have mercy. She only needed some crumbs. Profoundly moved, Jesus responded with that same mercy that the mother knew he had all along. And Jesus said, woman, great is your faith. Let it be done for you as you wish. And it was. Jesus, in his mercy, had made her daughter whole. That Canaanite woman reminds me a little bit of a pastor or a celebrant during communion, the one who takes little bits of bread of the Lord's mercy and shares that feast among everyone. For like the Canaanite woman, you and I know our only hope is in the Lord. whose mercy makes all of us new. Hallelujah. In this difficult time, when problems are so many that we may not know how to pray, perhaps we can recite the Kyrie. For the ancients believed that was all that was needed. The word mercy encompasses all and every act, loving act of God. Hallelujah. Below in that, for those of you who have a copy of the sermon, is an ancient version of the Kyrie, prayed in Britain 500 years ago. No, 500 years before Martin Luther was even born. We're going to pray it together, those of you who have copy. I'll read the petition and you join in reading the responses. Your way, or have mercy on us. So Zoomers, please keep your mics muted. As we pray, listen for the foundational parts of the prayer. Remember, it's a Trinity thing. So let us pray this ancient Kyrie eleison. O Lord, maker of all creatures, have mercy on us. Blot out our sins and without ceasing, have mercy on us. Do not let humanity perish, which you have made, but in your pity, have mercy on us. O Christ, only Son of the Father, born of a virgin, have mercy on us. By your blood, you saved a lost world from death. Have mercy on us. Hear the prayers of those who now call on you. Have mercy on us. Kindly Spirit, fill us with your grace. Have mercy on us. You proceed continually from the Father and the Son. Have mercy on us. Holy Trinity, three in unity, adored together, have mercy on us. Free us from the bonds of our sins. Redeem us from death. Have mercy on us. Let us proclaim your praise, O God. Have mercy on us. Thanks be to God. Amen. It's time for special music by Gary. Music. Gary, it's time for music.
He's still muted.
Can we unmute him?
No.
No. He's playing. Thank you, Gary. Always wonderful. We'll continue with the Apostles' Creed.
With congregations around the world, we confess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. The third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Amen. Confident of your care and helped by the Holy Spirit, we pray for the church, the world, and all who are in it and in need. Lord, you gather the church to be part of your mission as ambassadors of Jesus Christ. As Jesus acknowledged the great faith of a woman from outside his people, help your church discover and find blessing in the faith of people we might reject. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You have blessed us with the bounty of the earth. Grant your grace to all your creatures that the earth will flourish. Relieve waters choked by garbage, renew soil stripped of nutrients, and refresh the air. All creatures need to live. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
You call the nations to be glad and sing for joy. Let your way be known among all the nations of the world, now divided by competing interests, contending alliances, and consumed by enormous worry. Bless us and make your face shine upon all. Lord, in your mercy,
Hear our prayer.
You show unexpected mercy, kindness, and generosity. We pray for those who do not have enough, for outcasts in our villages, cities, and towns, and for those who need your healing, especially, Lord, those who are on our prayer concerns list. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
In you we live and move and have our being. Grant our congregation, Calvary Lutheran, grace to find our life refreshed in you. Accompany us in the rhythms of late summer. Give us rest and renewal, and strengthen us in this time of pandemic for mission in your name, Lord. In your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We also pray for all of those on our prayer concerns list, as well as all of our members and friends, especially this week. We pray for Marjorie Springer, Carl and Carol, Wayne, Jim and Margaret, Ken and Kay, Deborah, Troy, Christina, Cameron, Jet, Reese, Talon, and Aubrey, as well as our members and friends serving us in the military, and our partners in ministry, the Lutheran churches in this area, as well as our ministers. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Your eternal promises are more than we could ever imagine. As you gather all the saints, join us also with them on the great day of your salvation. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
In the certain hope that nothing can separate us from your love, we offer these prayers to you through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
time to prepare for the sacrament. Let us begin. You are indeed holy, almighty, and merciful.
You are most holy, and great is the majesty of your glory.
You so loved the world that you gave your only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but have eternal life.
We give you thanks for his coming into the world to fulfill for us your holy will and to accomplish all things for our salvation.
Please open your pit and lift up the vapor. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus gave thanks and broke it and gave it to all his disciples, saying, "Take and eat, my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of the body of Christ broken for you. Please eat the wafer." Now please open and lift up the cup. Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me. The blood of Christ shed for you. Please drink of the cup." For as often as we eat of this bread and drink from this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes.
May we and all who share in the body and blood of Christ be filled with heavenly blessing and grace.
And receiving the forgiveness of sin, may we be formed to live as your holy people and be given our inheritance with all your saints.
Amen.
Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Let's continue with special music by Gary Klimp. Gary?
Thank you.
Looks like Dale is standing up, huh?
Thank you, Gary. Wonderful. Our after communion prayer.
She reading?
Hurry too fast. I'm falling apart here.
It's okay. We're just glad.
Let us pray. God of the welcome table, in this meal, we have feasted on your goodness and have been united by your presence among us. Empower us to go forth sustained by these gifts so that we may share your neighborly love with all. Through Jesus Christ, the giver of abundant life. Amen.
Amen.
It's our closing hymn by Jerry and Dennis. Praise to the Lord the Almighty. Blessing. Neither death nor life, nor angels nor rulers, nor things present nor things to come, nor powers nor height nor depth nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus. God, the Creator, Jesus, the Christ, then the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, bless you and keep you in eternal love.
Amen. Amen.
Time for the postlude.
You want to go in the church next week?
Maybe. I think we're on.
Oops, we're on.
Wonderful. Absolutely wonderful. Now, everyone needs to turn on your mics.
Okay, the last part.
Because we're going to the dismissal and then the threefold amen, and we need to be loud for that. We're going to rock the house. Okay, let's go.
Go in peace. Make God's love known.
Thank you, God. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, guys. Wonderful. Thank you for your patience. Sometimes it works smoother than others, but it was wonderful anyway. Thank you very, very much.
Thank you.
Great to see you. Have a good week. Geneva, it's great to see you. Can you hear me? We're so glad you're there. Megan, hello, Megan and Penny, hello. Have a great week, all of you. Love you all. Be good.
I would really like to say, because of course, that part of the sermon touched me personally. I want us to think about, we used to do backpack for, you know, at our church. Maybe next Sunday, I'm sure everybody in this congregation, either their children or their grandchildren, are being faced with this decision that Pastor Pat talked about. And I can tell you, it is a hard thing. Our daughter has been back for a full week. And, you know, it's hard on the kids. The kids, their kids are not going to school. She has to be there because she is their sole income. And that doesn't make her right or wrong or anybody. There is no right or wrong answer to this. But it is just amazing the impact it is having on children, teachers, and family. And I think it would be nice if we could set aside maybe a little moment to speak with so many of the children are at that decision. They haven't done it early in making that decision because it's not political. It is really a sad commentary on what our families are facing.
Thank you. Thank you, Dorothy, because it is really tough. I'm sure a lot of you are facing it either with your children or your grandchildren.
Oh.
And it's just painful. And we never thought we would be placed in a position where we might put our children in danger or the two.
All right, have fun. Talk to you later. Love you.
Yes.
A once in a lifetime event.
Anyway, bless you all this week, and we'll set aside to think about this. Thank you, Dorothy.
Exactly, and then can go along.
Bye, you guys. Have a good
week.
Stay safe. Stay well, and God bless you all.
Aren't they getting the option?